Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. My name is Daniela Scorza and I'm assistant professor at the Department of Engineering of the University of Naples Partenope. The title of the paper that I'm going to present you is A novel methodology for fatigue assessment of high-strength steels with non-metallic inclusions. The goal of the present work is to extend the critical plane-based multi-axial fatigue criterion proposed by Carpenteri et al. To estimate the fatigue strength of naturally defective high-strength steels under multi-axial loading by implementing the square root theory concept. In particular, the presentation is structured in the following sections: introduction, extension of the criterion in order to take into account for defect of non-metallic inclusions, description of the procedure to determine the maximum value of the square root theory, experimental validation, and finally, conclusions. As is well known, non-metallic inclusions are naturally occurring products formed during steel production and manufacturing treatment processes. Such inclusions are chemical compounds of metals such as iron, manganese, aluminium, and silicon with non-metals such as oxygen, carbon, and hydrogen, forming separated phases in the steel matrix. Non-metallic inclusions are one of the leading causes of fatigue failure regarding gearboxes, pipelines, railway wheels, crankshafts, and so on. As a matter of fact, such a phenomenon is very common for high-strength steels, for which several experimental studies have shown that both short and long lifetimes are affected by non-metallic inclusions. In order to consider the influence of such inclusions in estimating the fatigue lifetime, a critical plane-based criterion such as the Carpenteri et al. 1 may be employed in conjunction with the concept of square root theory proposed by Murakami and Yanase. The concept of square root theory was firstly introduced by Murakami et al. When, after a large experimental campaign on metallic specimens containing small artificial holes, they observed that the size of the defect was crucial to determine the fatigue strength, mainly in high-strength metals. As a matter of fact, they found a linear relationship between the threshold value of the stress intensity factor range and the square root area in a logarithmic scale, being such an area obtained as the projection of the crack into the plane perpendicular to the maximum principal stress. Moreover, Murakami et al. Observed a linear relationship between the material Vickers hardness and the threshold stress intensity factor range, leading to the expression here shown, used to define the material fatigue strength under normal loading. Murakami et al. Also observed that the non-metallic inclusions may be treated as small defects. Since usual inclusions are more than a single one, it is needed to consider a statistical distribution of them, providing for not a unique value of the strength limit, but an upper and a lower bound. The lower bound was computed by Murakami under normal loading condition by assuming that the inclusion with the maximum area is expected to become the fatigue fracture origin, and such an inclusion is just below the cross-section surface. Such assumptions lead to the relationship here reported by using the maximum square root area. Yanase and Endo proposed an analogous equation to estimate the lower bound fatigue strength under torsion. Different methods are available in the literature to estimate the maximum square root theory, and the procedure here used will be outlined in the following. The criterion proposed by Carpenteri et al. For multi-axial fatigue assessment of metallic components uses the following nonlinear relationship, where sigma AF and tau AF are the fatigue strengths at 2 million loading cycles for fully reversed normal and shear stresses respectively. The equivalent stress amplitude NEQA whose expression is reported, and the shear stress amplitude, CA, defined according to the maximum rectangular hull method, are computed on the critical plane. The normal W to this plane is defined by means of both the direction of maximum principal stress, at the time instant when such a stress attains its maximum value, and the angle delta, defined as here shown. The above multi-axial criterion is then coupled with the square root area parameter model by replacing such fatigue strengths with those obtained by the equations discussed in the previous slide, that is, sigma WL and tau WL. Now, in order to validate the criterion, the following experimental campaign available in the literature has been analyzed. The specimens made of AISI-4140 steel were cut from a broken power generator crankshaft. The fatigue tests were performed under load control by adopting fully reversed sinusoidal signal. The values of the ratio between the shear stress amplitude and the normal stress amplitude were equal to 0, 0.5, 1, 2, and infinity, with a phase shift equal to 0 degree, and 0.5, 1, and 2, with a phase shift equal to 90 degrees. The specimen complete rupture was used as the failure criterion, whereas the runout condition was in correspondence of 2 million loading cycles. The results obtained under multiaxial loading and the details regarding the material mechanical properties may be found in the references below. The fatigue strength under normal loading and torsion, respectively, were computed through an inclusion content analysis performed by Machado et al., and here the main steps and results are reported. Two cross sections were examined, one perpendicular to the specimen longitudinal axis, and the other one forming 45 degrees with the above axis. Each cross section was observed by a scanning electron microscope with an inspection area equal to 0.41 square millimeter. The biggest inclusion was identified and its area was computed as that enclosed by a smooth boundary line surrounding the inclusion. Such an operation was repeated 60 times for each cross section. The trend of a reduced variable y against the above maximum area was plotted, being such a reduced variable computed as a function of the return period t, that is defined as the ratio between two volumes, the volume associated to the useful cross-section and the standard inspection volume. The following inclusion distribution were computed. The first one for the cross-section perpendicular to the specimen longitudinal axis, and the second one for the cross-section forming an angle of 45 degrees with the above axis. Then, the computed value of the maximum square root area were 145 micron and 121 micron for the two cross sections, respectively. Finally, by using the equations previously shown and by considering 2 million loading cycles, the fatigue strengths under normal load and torsion are computed as 309 megapascal and 260 megapascal, respectively. The extended Carpentier et al. Criterion is then applied to simulate the uniaxial and multiaxial fatigue tests. More precisely, the equation here reported defines the endurance strength assessment by means of the elliptical domain in the shear stress amplitude against equivalent normal stress amplitude diagram as here shown, so that fatigue failure occurs if the point associated with a given experimental test lies out of the elliptical domain, whereas the safe points are those located inside such a domain. The error band equal to plus minus 10% and plus minus 20% are represented by dashed and dash dot lines, respectively. The full symbols refer to specimens that failed, whereas the empty ones refers to runouts. The red empty ones instead refer to loading conditions for which both failure and runout were experimentally observed. Here, the in-phase loading conditions are plotted, and we can observe that under fully reversed axial loading and multi-axial loading, the criterion estimates the failure of all test specimens, so that the results are too conservative, although almost all fall into the plus 20% scatter band. Whereas under fully reversed torsion loading, the estimations are in complete agreement with the experimental results. Here, the out-of-phase multiaxial loading conditions are plotted. As we can observe, the estimations are totally in agreement with the experimental data, with the exception of one point for the loading condition with shear to normal stress amplitude ratio equal to 0.5. The accuracy of the criterion is then evaluated through the error index here shown. The mean value of such an index is equal to 1.4% for all the loading conditions examined. A comparison is performed by applying the Findlay criterion and the modified Wöhler curve method. As can be noted, a more satisfactory accuracy is obtained by applying the Carpenteri et al. Criterion, being the error index mean value lower than 10% for both in and out of phase loading conditions. Now, an optimization of the control volume is performed. As has been previously mentioned, the value of the volume, V, has to be set. So different values are considered, as here listed, up to a volume equal to the crankshaft 1. Note that the first one is the volume employed to obtain the results plotted in the previous slides. By repeating the aforementioned procedure for each volume, the error index mean value is computed. Such an index is also computed by using the experimental values of the fatigue strengths. Therefore, the error index mean values are plotted against the normal fatigue strength, and the points are interpolated by a parabolic curve. From the equation here reported, the error index is equal to 0 when sigma WL is equal to 313 megapascal. Now, by considering the equation defining sigma WL, the maximum square root area is obtained as equal to 135.16 micron. Then, the value of the optimum volume associated to the useful cross-section is determined, and the fatigue strength under torsion at 2 million loading cycles is finally computed as 263 megapascal. By employing these values of the fatigue strengths, new results are obtained and plotted in the figures. And now let us move to the conclusions. In the present work, the authors have proposed to extend the Carpenteri et al. Criterion to fatigue assessment of high-strength steels characterized by a fatigue life strongly influenced by non-metallic inclusions. To such an aim, the above multiaxial criterion has been used in conjunction with the square root area concepts proposed by Murakami and Yanase. The extended criterion has been applied to an experimental campaign available in the literature and performed on AISI 4140 steel specimens. The results have been quite satisfactory, being the criterion accuracy higher than that of two other criteria available in the literature. On the basis of such results, it has been observed that the volume of the specimen gauge length region is suitable since a very low error index mean value is obtained. Moreover, an optimization procedure has been employed in order to find the volume corresponding to an error index mean value equal to zero. Thank you for the kind attention.